enjoy coves of turquoise water, so clear that the boat seems to be floating in the air. Visit lighthouses with the endless views and unforgettable sunsets. That's life on the largest of the Balearic island, Mallorca, a place of idyllic landscapes where the mountains are just a step away from the beach. In the last video, we started our journey from the northeastern part of Mallorca and covered the exotic beaches, old cities and ancient castle. In this video, we will continue and explore more of the beaches, towns, cathedrals, castles, lighthouses, etc. Another must recommended stop on the eastern coast of Mallorca is Cala Figuera. In Cala Figuera, the Balearic island has retained its original appearance, and you are a guest in what is probably the most beautiful fishing village in Mallorca. The two-part sea bay is located on the southeast coast of Mallorca and has a Y shape. It is a working fishing port and has no beach, so it really felt tugged away from the tourist side of the island. White houses nestle against the fjord-like bay of Cala Figuera. The fresh green of the fig trees shines and bathes the harbour in a picturesque setting. Here are the houses of the fishermen with the associated garages for the boats. If you stroll through the town, you will notice that it is still very quiet during the day, perfect for strolling through the picturesque alleys. Are you a true beach lovers and a sun worshippers? How about a day at Cala Lombards? This bay is one of the most beautiful places in the east coast of Mallorca. The water here is particularly clear and clean, and the panoramic view is impressive. It is surrounded by an impressive cliff landscape covered with pines and pines. The atmosphere at Cala Lombards has an almost Caribbean feel. The crystal clear water glows turquoise blue and the white sand glistens in the bright sunshine. There is hardly any swell in this sheltered bay. Even toddlers under parental supervision can safely splash around at the water's edge. Another beach on the eastern coast of an island which cannot be missed is Cala Domingos. Cala Domingos is located about 20 kilometers from Menacor. You can easily reach the bay by car, and you will find the parking spaces in the immediate vicinity of the beaches. This beach is located in a landscape covered with bushes. It is a larger beach of a double bay and is also called as Domingos Grands. The subsequent smaller beach can be reached on foot or by swimming. A After exploring the eastern coast of Mallorca, let's slip and see the west coast of Mallorca. As I told you that this island has something for everyone. The western coast of Mallorca offers great views of mountains, beautiful hikes, old towns and beaches. Soler, this small town is nestled in an enchanting valley between oranges, lemons and olive groves, which is framed by the massive mountain ranges of Tramuntana, a dreamlike background. In 2011, Soler was granted UNESCO's World Heritage status. In the same year, the entire Serra da Tramuntana was declared a World Heritage Site. For a long time, Soler was quite isolated from the rest of the Mallorca because it could only be reached via a long and sometimes dangerous mountain path. Back then, it was much easier to ship the harvested citrus fruits to France than overland to Palma. Lined with numerous bars and cafes, the main square is Soler's beating heart and is home to the valley's striking landmark, the Church of Saint Bartholomew, which was built here in around 12th century and modified several times. Today, it is mainly characterized by Baroque decoration and stylistic elements. The tram that connects the city and the port flights its way across the magnificent square, ringing the bell. There are several hikes in this golden valley. On a hike, you will come across a cultural landscape that is unparalleled on the island. Most adventurous hikers might combine such a tour with a climb to one of the surrounding peaks of the Serra da Tramuntana. The artificial water reservoir located at the valleys of Puig Mayor and Morre de Cubeir on the island of Mallorca. The reservoir is at an altitude of 750 meters and was created in the late 60s and 70s. The main purpose of the reservoir is to supply the municipality of Palma with drinking water. Beautifully situated, the gorge Plough and Cubeir invite nature lovers to go hiking. The two reservoirs are connected by a canal that directs excess water from gorge Plough to the Cubeir reservoir. A beautiful hiking trail runs along this canal, from which you can enjoy an unforgettable view of the surrounding rock massives of Serra Tramuntana and the reservoir. The circular route around the lake is of about 5 kilometers and can be hiked in a 60-minute walk. New Desa Coberta. This is the highest point of a street across the highlands of Tramuntana. It makes a curve on this point with a beautiful view to the ocean. There is a small coffee shop around this area, so you can stroll a bit and enjoy the view from the top with a cup of coffee. Sa Calobra is a small village on the Balearic island of Mallorca. Despite the small number of inhabitants in this region, there are many exciting sites to discover. Sacalobra is located on the west coast of Mallorca in Serra de Tramuntana region, which is the World Heritage Site since 2011. Only about 100 people lives in this small village. If the holidaymakers don't just want to lie comfortably on the beach but want to be active, they can swim or do water sports. By far, the greatest attraction is the long walkway that runs along the scenic coast, right past the harbor and then through the narrow tunnel. This brings visitors directly to the beautiful Torrente de Paris, the Grand Canyon of Mallorca. In the middle of a ravine through which a torrent of the same name flows into the sea. The way to this beach is already an experience, as you have to pass two narrow caves. Afterward, you relax on white sand and enjoy a unique view of the Mediterranean Sea. It is a descending canyon of about 3300 meters surrounded by rock formations about 200 meters high. The hike for Torrente de Paris starts from the city Escorca, located in the northwest Mallorca, and goes all the way down seaside to Sacalobra. Hike around these canyons are difficult and it is recommended to never hike there alone, especially when there is a water. Be careful with the extremely slippery rocks if it has rained even a little bit. Platja de Alcudia. Platja de Alcudia is the longest sandy beach in Mallorca and consists of four areas totaling 6 kilometers. This beach is perfect for all ages and popular with both tourists and locals. It is particularly popular with families due to easy access, variety of restaurants and facilities, range of children's activity and exceptionally shallow water that allow you to wade out before deepening. Overall, this beach is a very popular holiday destination as all hotels and apartments are within the walking distance of the beach. The Levant Peninsula, a natural park in the unspoiled northeast. This hilly terrain could almost pass for the Scottish Highland with its covering of heathers and shrubs at the higher altitudes. This area was declared a national park in 2002 and is re-owned for its remote and unspoiled beaches and its colonies for Mediterranean tortoises. You can drive through the reserve up a narrow road if you prefer not to walk, and the views from the top down on to the Bay of Alcudaina are astounding. Palma, the largest and the oldest town in Mallorca. Feel the history beneath your feet in Old Town. The gorgeous streets of Palma's old town are a sight to behold. The city is appealing year-round with an explosion of urban beaches, fashionable bars with views, museums and art galleries, traditional food, etc. But the one thing which cannot be missed is La Suy Cathedral. The mighty La Suy Cathedral is considered the most important art historical site in the Balearic Islands and now is the seat of the Diocese of Mallorca. Majestic and visible from afar, the monumental building in honor of St. Mary rises above the harbor in the sky. Cap de Fort Mentor, the most beautiful vantage point on the island. If you don't want to miss the fantastic view along the curvy peninsula, a trip to the Cap de Fort Mentor with the lighthouse is ideal at any time of the year.